when I was 20 years old. So I was fresh out of college, just got that bachelor's degree, and definitely had an entitlement hat on of, I'm entitled to make a job that I'm going to make, you know, 500 grand or more a year with my 4-year bachelor degree. So obviously that was not the case. So I went for an interview, and in that interview, I didn't really understand before going that it was for life insurance. However, I was really thankful that it got me into the industry. So was I with Family First Life? No, it would have looked a lot different. However, at this practice company, what it really taught me is if you don't have high activity in this business, you are going to run yourself out of business extremely fast. And you're going to feel really bad about yourself. And I don't say that so that anybody feels bad about themselves. I say it more so that we're aware, right? Because what happened to me when I came into the industry was my first month, and again, I was not with Family First Life, I couldn't sell a policy to my own sister. And I'm not kidding, she didn't have one, I swear to God. I was just that, I didn't get it. It wasn't clicking, right? I was 20, I was like, oh, I don't really know what I'm doing, but it's okay. But then it started becoming not okay, right? Because I needed to provide for myself. I didn't have mom, dad to lean on. It was just Marysa. So I was like, okay, let me get it together here. And really what getting it together for me was realizing that I had to go out and see people if I wasn't able to have a full dial day. I had to go out and get uncomfortable if I wasn't able to book 16 appointments. Regardless, I'm gonna be out there. So when we're out there and we get a no-show, we have a choice at that point, right? We're either gonna go to the CVS parking lot and we're gonna call our friend and we're gonna talk about how we don't believe that Debbie wasn't home. Or we're gonna stay active in the field and we're not even gonna notice that Debbie isn't home, because for every single appointment we set up, we have 5 door knocks scheduled. So just to give an example, let's just say I have John in Hartford at 8 a.m., okay? Now, I'm on my way to John's house, and I'm gonna make sure that if John's not there, in a folder, so again, we have to organize this, in a folder, I have 5 other places in Hartford, as an example, that I'm going to be going. That way, if John's not going, I still have 5 more at-bats to make sure that I'm able to help the family, and also to resolve my leads. Guys, if you have a lead binder that has, like, 500 leads in it, like, I love you guys, but you gotta get it together. There's only one way, it's to resolve the leads, right? So essentially, with that being said, I went ahead and realized high activity was winning. So my first year in insurance, I was so bad on the phones, like, again, I probably would have called my sister, she would have hung up on. But what I realized was I didn't need to be that great on the phone, I just needed to be willing to be bad long enough, right? And what I did in the meantime was I went and I door knocked. And when I say leads, like, these leads were bait and switch. It's like, oh, did you get your child safe kit yet? So essentially, you know, that's what I'm knocking on people's doors and saying, and that's how I'm getting into homes. However, now how does that relate to Family First Life? Now, if they're both insurance. However, here at Family First Life, we have leads, guys. We have a form that somebody filled out, whether it was handwritten, it was online, it was on Facebook, it doesn't matter. We have to utilize that. If we don't, just like Rami said, we could be leaving somebody in this room's family unprotected. Because I know that for most of my family members, if they don't know the number, they're not answering the phone. They don't care if you call 3 times, 20 times. And 90% of the times I door knock, they're like, oh yeah, I never answer the phone. I'm always like, oh, you know, I'm Marysa, you must be John, nice to meet you. I'm actually following up with you, so it doesn't seem like you're the kind of guy who answers the phone, right? He's like, oh no, right? So that's how you're getting in homes, that's how you're keeping your activity high. So just to kind of give you guys some actual practical things that you can do when you're in the field or before you're in the field. So if you're trying to hit a goal, you want to make sure, again, so if you set 8 and 8, you know, you're dialing for Monday, you want 16 appointments ideally, right? You want 8 for Tuesday, you want 8 for Wednesday. That's in an ideal world. Is it always going to happen that way? No, but let's say it does. You're going to have 5 door knocks set up for each and every appointment that you have. So 8 times 5 is 40, times 2 is 80. Let's say all 16 of those appointments no-show lead. That's probably not gonna happen, but let's say it does. You still have 80 people to go see, right? You're gonna tell me you're not gonna pull something out of that? It's about what is your attitude, right? Like, where's your wavelength? Is it I can do this no matter what? Or is it I'm not really sure if I can do this because I got one no-show earlier and I only booked 3 appointments yesterday. But that's your fault. Just like Steve G said when he was up here, he said, you know, I'm not really worried about Monday, but I'm worried about what it's gonna feel like in the field on Tuesday and Wednesday. And that's a real feeling, guys. So essentially, the way that I look at it is you have to believe in yourself and you have to have self-accountability. So if we don't have self-accountability, we're not going to do these things. And by default, if I say I'm going to wake up by 5 a.m. tomorrow, I'm going to go to the gym, I'm going to, you know, bang out these three things before I get my day going, get in the shower and do it. By default, if I do that, I'm going to feel better about myself, just by actual default. And in this business, we need a couple of things. We need to care about people, and we need a little bit of self-confidence. And sometimes that self-confidence has to be borrowed. And that's okay, because you'll build your own confidence through activity. And that's exactly what I went ahead and did, was I got confident through the activity I was doing, because it was breeding a result. So again, belief and self-accountability equals self-confidence. And then also, when you're busy, like when you're in the field and you have 8 appointments, it looks a lot different than when you're in the field and you have 2 appointments. You're like, oh, my first one's at 3, my last one's at 5. I'm just gonna swing out there and come back home. But we are an extremely lucrative business. Like, what made you so special, right? That you only had to book 2. And what we're doing too is, when we're door knocking and we're getting in front of people, we're moving that bell curve of 100 families, right? We all talk about, you sit in front of 100 families, right? You do 100 presentations, you're gonna know a lot more than you did on your first day. Why are we not moving that bell curve quicker? Because I have agents, but they go, I booked 8 appointments last week. Okay, that's great, but you have to realize that's a half a week. You only booked a half a week. Some of us only book, you know, a quarter of the month. It's okay, but we have to recognize that and fill it in with activity that's gonna become income producing. Other things you should be doing in the field. This is a great one, and this is one I literally live by. 2x2s. I probably would have helped 100 less families last year if I didn't do 2x2s. So a 2x2, I'm gonna give an example of with appointments, an example of without appointments. So 2x2 meaning, let's just say I have an appointment with John at 8 a.m. I gave myself this W-2 mindset, if you will. Meaning, I'm in the field from 8 in the morning until 8 p.m. Like, because if my boss told me that I work 8 to 8, it wasn't gonna be like, oh, I just go to my 2 or 3 o'clock and then I'm done with it. No, I'm gonna be working 8 to 8, figure it out. Get income producing activities going. And when you're busy, you don't have time to think about negative things. And usually positive things, you know, will come out of it. So 2x2s. What this means, let's just say I have John at 8 a.m. tomorrow on Tuesday. I'm gonna get to John's house or area, and I'm gonna pull over about 2 to 5 minutes before I get there. I always have my leads on me. You don't always have your leads on you, please start bringing them with you everywhere. I literally have lead anxiety, okay? You gotta bring them everywhere, okay? You never know. So with that being said, I'll pull over 2 to 5 minutes before I get there, pick up my lead stack, and I'll be dialing on my leads until I talk to at least 2 people. My goal here is, I want to book the appointment, yes. Could I pull a telesale? Absolutely. There's a lot of different things that could come out of this. But even if these 2 people simply just tell me no, like, no, I don't want to talk to you, fly a kite. Okay, cool. At least I was able to resolve 2 more leads. So now I'm going to go into John's house at my 8 a.m. And, you know, let's just say, you know, me and John sit there and, you know, we help his family or we don't, either way. I'm going to come out of the house and I'm going to drive down the street because we don't want to freak John out. That's like really creepy. You can just like stay in front of someone's house after the appointment for like more than 30 seconds. Please don't do that. But then I'm going to go to John's house. I'm going to leave John's house, drive down the street, and I'm going to pick up my lead binder. And again, I'm going to dial until I talk to 2 more people. And guess what? When my schedule is full, I'm dialing like a maniac. And that's the way you should be dialing and dialing, guys. Because that's how you get the most activity out of it. So I'm going to call 2 more people until I get them on the phone. Again, I'm either booking them, I'm resolving the lead. I'm getting a yes or I'm getting a no. And now I'm going to do that through my whole entire day. Now let's say, you know, you don't have any appointments, right? We all been there one time, like we had no appointments, right? I know I've been there a couple of times. So the way that I'm going to work that is a little bit backwards. So when somebody has no appointments, it's not exciting, but we can make it exciting, right? Through high levels of activity. So what that's going to look like is, okay, if I'm talking to Rami and he tells me he doesn't have any appointments, which probably isn't going to happen anytime soon. However, what I'm going to tell him is, okay, Rami, we're going to use the 2x2 rule. And we're going to use it from 8 a.m. until 8 p.m. because those are your hours, right? And again, that's up to the agent, that's up to you. This is going to be my advice. Is you're going to do the same thing. You're going to get out there. Your first dial is going to go out at 8 o'clock. And you're going to be door knocking a synchronized route through Road Warrior. If you don't have Road Warrior, download it. It synchronizes the doorknob group for you. It's a beautiful app. So I'm going to have them download Road Warrior, and again, you're doing 2x2s, except this time, you're calling until you talk to two people on the phone. Again, you're getting a yes, no, whatever it may be. And then from there, you're going, you're door knocking that lead. So you go, you're door knocking, you know, Eric's house. Whether Eric's home or it's not home, whatever happens, there happens, you're going to come out, drive down the street, over to your next doorknob, halfway there, pull over, call two more people. You want high activity, you want to win here, that's how you're going to win. You can't lose with that level of activity. And that's really what I've learned in this industry. Last couple things for you guys is, you know, somebody said this to me, and it's cliche, but hustle beats talent when talent doesn't hustle. And it was said to me when I was 20 years old, because I said, I think a lot of these people are just a lot more talented than me. And, you know, now I'm in hindsight, well, that's kind of funny, because they definitely were up even playing field here. And he said to me, well, you know what, even if you feel that way, you have to remember something. If you can outwork anyone, you can win. Meaning hustle beats talent when talent doesn't hustle. So guys, if you want to get out there, you know, you have to focus on your mindset, your belief, your self-accountability. What are you saying you're going to do that you're not doing? Start doing it. Even if it's like you say you're going to eat broccoli every night instead of cash grabs. Like, start doing it because you're going to feel better about yourself. And then last thing I always just like to kind of end with is, three questions Sean asked me when I first got started are, where are you now, where do you want to be, and what are you willing to give up to get there? And those are three questions you have to ask yourself every single time you're in the field and you're faced with a choice of, what am I going to do right now? Am I going to go door knock, or am I going to feel bad for myself? Then your 3 o'clock isn't going to really help light your vibe. But with that being said, thank you guys so much for having us up here.